Dear friends, we're learning about the fact that Noah built the ark. Most people know about this story. There was a flood that destroyed the world. And we also know that for 120 years, Noah was busy building the ark that would save his family and the animals. Why did it take so long to build the ark? That is because for 120 years, people came to him, hearing the noise from all the building and asking what's going on. And Noah would tell people over and over again that the flood is coming, you have to repent, you have to change your ways. But people did not listen. Very often in life, we get signs, we hear noises, we know that God is calling us, but we choose to ignore it. Unfortunately, that's exactly what happened in the story of Noah. Noah was called the righteous among his generation. We wonder why that we add that he was righteous amongst the generation he lived in, not in general, just a righteous person. And that is because while he was busy saving the animals and his family, he did not plead to God asking to save the humanity. We know later in life Moses was willing to die with Jewish people, but not allow Jewish people to suffer. And so we learn that we are responsible for each other. We cannot just simply say, as long as I'm safe, as long as my family is okay, I don't care. We are each other's keepers. And so when the world became new again and the flood ended, we know that people united and built a tower of Babel. Together, they wanted to become powerful and not need godly energy in the world. And they were united, and because of that, while God scattered them amongst this planet and gave 70 different languages to 70 different nations, we know very well that they were not destroyed because they were united. When we're united, we are forgiven from many of our transgressions. Unity amongst people is a very powerful gift. And therefore, I would like to bless us with caring for each other, with unity, with meaningful life, and getting the point that when God is talking to us, when we hear that noise calling us, we should repent, we should think and evaluate our lives. Have a wonderful and meaningful week ahead.